today is going to be a video on one of the aspects which is very important to the United States medical licensing exam. In the past few weeks, I have had a lot of people reach out to me on a very controversial topic, and that is the United States clinical experience. USCE in a time of COVID is very difficult. A lot of countries all over the world, the cases of COVID are probably coming under control or are still rampant, which is why telemedicine rotations is now the new normal. So what is telemedicine rotations? How do you get it? Is it worth it? And what are the pros and cons? These are some of the most important topics about telemedicine rotations that I am going to touch on this video. So before we go any further on this telemedicine rotation journey, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Now let's start our telemedicine rotation journey. So why is this important and how can I be helpful? As an applicant in the pandemic year myself, I solely applied to all the universities on the basis of clinical experience in the form of telemedicine only. Even though I had already secured my rotations in FIU, that is Florida International University, and the University of Alabama, these electives got cancelled because of the pandemic and I had to rely on the telemedicine rotations alone. So I'm very sure that my tips and tricks and my points of view on telemedicine rotations will definitely ease your journey and help you make an informed decision. So to start with, let me take you across my pros and cons list that I made while deciding to do telemedicine rotations. Alright, so first of all, we will get the negatives out of the way. Alright, so the very first con on my list while doing a virtual telemedicine rotation was that I cannot touch the patient. And not being able to touch a patient kind of hampers your clinical skills and also hampers the ability of your attending to vouch for your bedside manners. Secondly, if you are doing a telemedicine rotation, that means you are not in the United States of America. So this hampers your ability to understand the work culture that is present in the hospitals of America. How people take their histories, how they put in notes, how they do counseling for a variety of diseases, and how you generally approach the patient. So the third and a very common complaint while doing telemedicine rotations is that you are not able to maintain your contacts. So by contacts, I mean people who you have worked with, who can vouch for your skills and who you can approach in the time of crisis, who know you, who know your skill set, who know your work ethic, and who also know if you will be a good fit into this program or not. So contacts include your attendings, your colleagues, the interns and the residents who are in that rotation with you. However, let me reassure you, as a telemedicine applicant myself, I built a very good rapport with my attending and with my colleagues. We had a WhatsApp group, we used to discuss cases, and even today I can reach out to my attending and ask for her advice. So, telemedicine is not all bad, it's an informed decision that you must take. So for that, let me take you to the pros list. So the pros list, the very first pro of a telemedicine rotation is that it is a unique skill set. With COVID rampant, a lot of people and a lot of healthcare workers all over the world have understood the importance of telemedicine rotation. Even if you are applying to universities and giving interviews, your telemedicine rotation can be shown as a unique skill set besides the on-site rotations that you might have had. Secondly, and actually the most important aspect, it saves you a lot of finances. You are actually saving on a US trip. You will be saving on lodging, fooding. In a financial point of view, telemedicine rotations are very cost effective. They help you meet your goal. If you perform very well, you are granted a letter of recommendation on a hospital letterhead. And that is what makes your application stand out. So the third and the most important aspect of a telemedicine rotation is that it saves you on a lot of time on your timeline to apply for the residency programs. So if you are doing a telemedicine rotation and, for example, you're in America itself, you are in the same time zone. You can definitely do a lot more studying for your steps along with pursuing a telemedicine rotation. If, for example, you are abroad and you cannot do this, all it takes is a little tweaking in your timeline to get you oriented and get you a more productive output while doing a telemedicine rotation. So these were some of the pros and cons that I had made about telemedicine rotations when I was pursuing them. So now let's come to the most important aspect of a telemedicine rotation and a question that I have been asked a multiple number of times in the last few weeks. And that is, where do I get my USCE? So USCE in the form of telemedicine rotations is offered by a lot of companies. Companies such as US Emily Sarthi, companies like Brooklyn USCE and also AMA. I'll be putting the links down below for their sites and you can choose whichever you find best. As a US Emily Sarthi student myself, if you guys would like to know how my experience was and where I did my telemedicine rotations, you can definitely drop in your comments down below and I will make a separate video for it. So only when you are satisfied with what you will be getting out of the USCE do you pick one. Do not just rush into a USCE as a telemedicine just because there is one. Definitely pick one that suits you the best. Alright, so coming to the next question about USCE is that, are telemedicine rotations even worth it? Alright, so in my experience as a solely telemedicine focused applicant, USCE worked in my favor a lot. I pre-matched in New York in my top priority hospital, which is One Brooklyn Health System. So definitely, I would say that telemedicine rotations are worth it. Like I said, it is a pro because it is a unique skill set. Even if you have planned your USCE, I would suggest that you simultaneously pick up a telemedicine rotation and do it, because this can be portrayed in your interviews as a very different skill set where you know how to handle a patient that is on screen, who you cannot touch, who you cannot palpate, but you can diagnose and treat. So this is an aspect which is very important for every doctor to attain. So telemedicine rotations, in my opinion, would be very worth it, but the rest is up to you. As an applicant, you have to put your best foot forward and what you feel the most comfortable in. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, recommend this channel to your friends, and you will have a lot more content coming upon various aspects of the USMLE application and how to go about it. So until then, don't forget to smile, sparkle and shine, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.